Lord Dalhousie, the Governor General from 1848 to 1856, devised the doctrine. It stated that a kingdom could be annexed if the king died without a male heir. What does it mean? Basically, this policy was to expand British kingdom in India, to annex the independent Indian states, separating those states which have no heir, meaning thereby, if the king died without a male heir, meaning thereby the son, then that kingdom will be annexed by the Britishers and it will not be reverted by adoption. It means that adopted son can't take over that kingdom. According to this policy, many kingdoms were annexed, like Satara, Sambalpur, Udaipur, Nagpur, Jhansi, and Awadh. Next is subsidiary alliance. According to the terms of this alliance, Indian rulers were not allowed to have their independent forces. They were to be protected by the company and had to pay for the subsidiary forces. I'll make it more clear. It means that an Indian ruler entering into a subsidiary alliance with British had to accept British forces in his territory and agree to pay for their maintenance. And if they failed to pay for the alliance, then they were forced to give over parts of their territory. As under Richard Wellesley, as the Governor General, the Nawab of Awadh and Hyderabad, they were forced to give over parts of their territory. Why? Because they were not able, they failed to pay for the alliance. Clear? Students, now after discussing the above various causes of the revolt, it is clear that tension was smearing among Indians and they were full of anger against British. The only thing needed was just a spark for the outbreak of the revolt. And from where did this spark came from? This spark came from the Enfield rifle. Yes, this Enfield rifle was the immediate cause for the revolt. A rumor spread that the new cartridge to be loaded in the Enfield rifle was greased with the fat of cow and pig. And when this rumor spread, the Indians, Hindus and Muslims, they refused to use this cartridge. Why they refused? Because Hindus, they worship cow, and in Muslims, pig meat was forbidden by Quran. Quran is their holy book which forbids to use pig meat. That's why this Enfield rifle became the immediate cause for the revolt. Now, as the revolt outbroken, it slowly and gradually covered various places. Important centers of the revolt were Meerut, Delhi, Oudh, Kanpur, Jhansi, Gwalior. Many of the common people, like the peasants and artisans, they also joined the revolt. Now, we come to the reasons for the failure of the revolt. There were many reasons for the failure of the revolt. All the reasons have been discussed in the next slide. These are some of the reasons for failure of revolt. The first is lack of unity among Indians. There was really a lack of unity among the Indians. Then lack of national leader. There was no leader who could lead everyone. Then lack of resources. If we compare, then Indians were having less resources as compared to British, and this revolt was localized. Leaders also lacked military skills. Aftermath of the revolt. What were the results of the revolt? First and foremost, the rise of nationalism. This revolt created the feeling of nationalism among the Indians. Then reorganization of British Empire in India, which means a new act in 1858 was passed, and the powers of East India Company, all these powers were transferred to British Crown. Then all ruling chiefs were assured that their territories would never be annexed in future and were allowed to pass their kingdom to their heirs, including adopted sons. Then fourth one is Queen Victoria's proclamation. It states that respect for rights and dignity of the people will be maintained and general pardon will be given to all except murderers. Then Indian Army was reorganized, including Sikhs, Gurkhas and Pathans. And respect for religious and social practices of people in India was maintained. Thus, a new phase of history begins. Now, I think you all are well aware about this revolt of 1857. As we discussed, we'll recapitulate. Firstly, we discuss that how does it outbroken, then its various causes, reasons for the failure, major centers of the revolt, then what were the results of the revolt. So students, please make this concept clear. All the best. Thank you.